as we look to kind of restart the economy once we have a vaccine in place, we've got to have some, we need almost like a new deal. We have needed it for 2 decades, but this pandemic has made it worse.
Do you feel like it's a redesign of capitalism, or how does that manifest itself?
I mean, I think the quarter-to-quarter stuff, nobody likes it. If you asked any CEO, they don't, I mean, other than juicing their own bonus, they don't really like it either. I mean, it doesn't allow them to make the big long-term bets they want to make. It doesn't allow them to invest in their people. It doesn't involve them to less than their, invest in their potential. We're all sick of it. So when the Business Roundtable last fall said it was the end of the shareholder value era, they didn't really have a replacement. I mean, they sort of said an economy for the good of all, and that was a little squishy. And they've done some things in the pandemic. They made some stakes, and there were some companies early on. Rachel Carson from Guild Education got 1,500 CEOs to sign on to pledges about paying small businesses early, giving sick leave, all that kind of stuff, which was fantastic. Now, what's the next phase of it? I mean, I'm trying to popularize this world that the human capital era is coming, where the human is your best investment. Productivity is going to be the domain of technology. We're going to hand everything off as soon as we can figure out how to do it. The new stuff is all the stuff humans can do. It's the stuff we're uniquely good at.
It strikes me that a lot of people probably live two lives, the live from 9 to 5 and the alternate life from 5 to 9, right? That they're a different person at home than at work. How do we make that one life?
Well, I think, you know, like if my dog ran in right now and jumped in my lap, I'd say, well, this is my dog, blah, blah. The veil drops. I think all of us zooming from home, the kid who runs into the room and, you
Right.
know, the light that falls over in the background and you realize it's a green screen and they're really in their bedroom. You know, the veneer is falling with this virtual world and it's merging. And so my hope is that more authentic selves come out of it and our desire to. And I think post-pandemic, you know, we may see that it becomes work life, it becomes work life, work life, work life. Where you say, you know, I'm prioritizing being with my kids when they get home from school, or I am prioritizing having a drink with my husband or wife at 5 o'clock. And I may work in an environment where 7 to 9, I do something and I go running in the morning and swimming in the afternoon and whatever it may be, that we get the full potential out of humans because we're not bound by an old industrial schedule.